Hello and welcome to a week of workouts with me. So I'm currently at the end of my dieting phase, so please just keep in mind that this is a lot of expenditure. Bless me. Bless you. Say bless you in the comments below. Anyways, bear in mind this is a lot of expenditure. It's not what I usually do, especially with all the cardio, but I just wanted to show you guys, basically what my week has looked like in terms of resistance training, also my run training, and then also cardio on top. So enjoy this. Make sure to give it a like and subscribe if you're new here. And yeah, grab some popcorn, grab some nice food, and let's go to Monday.
All right, so pre-workout Monday, so just 2 rice cakes, 30 grams of banana, 10 grams of jam, and 10 grams of peanut butter. Alright guys, so we're 20 minutes in and I'm almost at 10k steps, but I don't count my running steps in, so that means I'll probably come downstairs like in the evening just to walk for another 30 minutes, and that should be like 10k, so around an hour of walking. I just wanted to pop on here quickly to talk about my current cut, but also if you're maybe in a position where you're like, oh, I'm really comfortable, so why bother, you know, setting any sort of goals for myself in terms of maybe performance or even physique-based goals. I wanted to talk about, you know, chasing goals beyond just for the reason of running away from pain or from not liking your body. You can set physique goals and continue to strive to become better regardless of how you feel. Like, you could be really confident and comfortable in your body right now, but I think it's a form of self-love and self-care and also personal development to be like, you know what, but I can still become better. Like, I can challenge myself. Why not go through a dieting phase and maybe set a goal of a photo shoot, right? Like, there are always more goals that you can strive towards, and there's always ways that you can really develop yourself as a person, and you learn so much through like doing hard things. So, you know, like, I was completely comfortable in my body and my skin before my cut. You know, I was running for a marathon. I was just performance-based, totally focused on performance. And you know, I really finally got to a place in my life where I was just so comfortable. Like, I was the heaviest I'd ever been, but I was genuinely so just comfortable and confident in my own skin. But I also really missed the challenge that obviously having a more physique-based goals also provides. I miss, you know, the discipline as well, and the mental like grit you need in order to go through a cutting phase, because it does require more time from you in terms of getting those steps in, cardio, you know, tracking your foods to the T. I wasn't really training for a good year, just because, again, like, I know how to maintain, you know, and I know how to just listen to my body, and I wasn't too fussed on physique-based goals. But if you are chasing a physique-based goal, it is important that you are, you know, on top of your nutrition, because that is going to make or break how you look. But I was like, you know what, I really miss that challenge. I'm up for it. You know, in a cutting phase, it gives me so much clarity and so much productivity as well. It improves my productivity because I'm so focused on my time, making sure I get everything done in a day. So if you're watching this and you're like comfortable in your own skin right now, but you're like, you know what, I know I could become better, do yourself a big favor. Set a goal that maybe scares you a little bit, a goal that's a little bit out of your comfort zone, so that you have something to work towards that's personal, because we all have career-based goals, we all have all these other things going on, but it's the most rewarding thing, having something that's personal just for you. Like, you're doing it just for you, not because you hate yourself, not because you're really uncomfortable in your own body, but you know, like, you can always become better and you can always push yourself out of the comfort zone. We're actually doing quite a few photo shoots, we're planning on photo shoots worldwide next year within our coaching community. So there's quite a few girls based in LA and New York, some in Australia as well, New Zealand, obviously Asia. Oh my God, my arm. Oh, and Dubai right now. This is like an arm workout, but we're planning on doing like a tour around the world next year and planning on some photo shoot dates. So if a photo shoot is something you're like, you know what, I would love to be able to say I've done this in my life, and I'd love for someone to really push me to see where my limits are and to see where I can get my body to celebrate this and to just go through like a photo shoot prep, just message me photo shoot on Instagram, that's cz.fit. And then we can look at getting you joining for like a photo shoot prep. We can go through all the details, but it would be so incredible. And yeah, I think it's just such a great way to celebrate, you know, your hard work, yourself, capture like a moment in your life. Imagine looking back in like 30 years time being like, that's me. Wow, like I did that. Anyways, my arm is going to fall off. So I will catch you guys in the next day on my next workout. See you.
Hello, happy Tuesday. So it is the next morning and I'm just about to get my next workout done. So this morning, we're just going to do my run training. So that's 8 times 200 meters. I'm just going to do it on the treadmill downstairs. Currently my runs are basically towards just getting me faster and just fitter for my next marathon next year. So today, 8 times 200 meters. And then I'm just going to finish off with some steps. And then I'm headed to the gym this afternoon to do back and I believe biceps with Patrick and his brother Anthony. So yeah, just a full-on workout day really. I've blocked out my calendar actually today because I've been taking quite a few calls in the last few weeks and I realized it's really drained my energy. So I was like, I just need one day where I have a little less calls and just have a bit more like me time working on the business, working, you know, with my clients, looking at kind of admin stuff and things I just need to get ticked off. I have one call at 8 p.m. but that's pretty much it. Anyways, I'm just starting the day with a good 1.5 liters of water and obviously had my rice cakes to fuel myself before my workout. Also, I just wanted to, I was starting this like recording, right? And I was like, the old me never would have filmed myself without makeup. I know this sounds so like, it's not a big deal, but I don't know, like as someone who's obviously been vlogging for a while or just been on YouTube, Instagram, I've always felt like, I was always so like scared almost to not feel like put together on camera in the mornings. Like I feel like I have to get ready to vlog. And I don't know why, for me, like I'm quite a low maintenance person. So I think that's also something that really prevented me from vlogging more often was because I was like, oh, well, I'm not put together. I don't really want to put myself together as in like, I don't want to put on heaps of makeup. Obviously, like I follow a lot of like other content creators or influencers and I feel like they always just look so put together. Their hair's always done properly. Their makeup's beautiful. Even when I put on makeup, I don't know how to like do it properly in the way where like, you know, they put like 4 or 5 different things on their face and they do like the contouring and like, oh my god, it's like, I'm like, wow, this is amazing, but I could never do that. Like I actually just don't have the patience all the time. But no, I don't know, it's like, it's funny, like the older I get and especially just this year, and I think maybe it's because like my skin has gotten a lot better as well, I've recently just been like, I can't be arsed putting on makeup on anymore. And I finally, I think, found just so much comfort in who I am as a person. I'm like, you know what, if you can't accept me without my makeup, I don't care. That's a bit of a ramble, that's not a full week of workout kind of thing to bring up, but yeah, I just wanted to express that because it's nice. Anyways, let's get our run done. Okay, just warming down now, so I'm just walking, getting some steps in now. So I'm still hitting at least 10k steps. I've been averaging like 12 to 15 daily across the week. So yeah, just trying to get some steps in before a day or pretty much just sitting in front of my laptop and then obviously training later. I'll probably head up at like 7:30 and then get breakfast in and then start my first work block at by 8 a.m. I've got a call with Izzy today, so we have weekly meetings to basically go over all our clients. So we literally go through everyone's progress, everyone's weeks, how they've been feeling, how they've been going, and changes that we've made to their program for the following week or the next week. So yeah, that usually takes quite a while. And then I have a catch-up call with Terry, one of my clients in Australia. So we're mapping out her marathon training and then mapping out basically her next cut that she's going to do towards her first photo shoot in the Australian summer next year. So basically we're reversing her now so that she's nice and fueled for her run and just really focusing on performance. She's been injured for a while now, so yeah, it just hasn't been the smooth journey, but she's been an absolute star and just like pushing through. So we're gonna get the run done, really celebrate that, and then we'll be in a nice place where maintenance calories are higher, and then she can start a really nice dieting phase towards a photo shoot, so that's super exciting. So yeah, really, really exciting day ahead. That interval run was actually really decent. Like, these intervals, they're really fun. They just like, there's so much adrenaline going on because you're just like sprinting, you know, for like a minute and a half or something, and then you get that 1 minute's rest, 90, 60 seconds rest, and then you go again. It's a lot of fun, so highly recommend. All right guys, so we have now arrived at TK MMA and we're training outside because we're idiots. So we're just doing a back and by day. We've got the two brothers here again.
The hot brothers.
They like training with me because I inspire them. That's what they told me. So here I am. So I'm here to inspire them with my strong back. Anyways, we're starting off with some barbell rows. And then I don't know what we're gonna move into. I'm just gonna follow them for today. Subscribe please, because 40% of you guys who are watching are not subscribed. Like, what the fuck are you doing?
What? 40 fucking percent?
I know, it's crazy. It's like, what are they doing in their spare time if they're not subscribed to me?
Right?
Like, living their life?
Look, if they call
what
it that.
What the fuck?
There's no life without subscribing.
Exactly! So make sure you subscribe!
It's 2023, you live vicariously. That's how you live! What are we doing here, Chen?
We're doing a seated row.
Seated row?
Oh, that's quite heavy.
That's your heavy. Oh, it's your heavy set. Oh,
actually, it's not too bad. It's really not heavy. Okay, that's way too light. Sometimes you gotta test the waters first, you know.
Test the waters.
You're not too sure how heavy it's gonna be.
Capturing content, underpaid
your behaves.
How sick is this, guys? Like, this is like part of my gym rules. They have like the form bottles. Like, how much is in there?
1 million, baby.
1 million.
Is that what 1 million?
This is so Dubai.
In dubs, isn't it? A bit bougie, isn't it?
Just 1 million lying there.
But Lavar's the best coffee.
So sick.
Best leader in the world. Best motorbike brand.
Okay.
Best sofa. So at the minute, it's alright. No, we've got Andrew Tate on it. But lesson, they're going to go down.
Alright guys, so back home and I'm still dripping in sweat, but that was a back workout done. I'm gonna drop down all the workouts below in the captions or the description box, so if you wanna like give it a try, you can do so. How sick was that like barbershop outside our gym? It's a newly like developed area, but oh my gosh, it's so Dubai. But anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this workout and I will see you guys tomorrow. So tomorrow I have another sports massage, and then I'm gonna probably train shoulders. I was gonna do legs tomorrow, but I'm not gonna do that after a sports massage. So, slight bit of a blip in terms of my split, but that's okay. We'll do shoulders tomorrow, bring you guys along. Also just finished up at the gym with a lot of like reel filming, so film some form techniques. So if you aren't following my Instagram, that's cz.fit, make sure to check me out over there. But yeah, we basically went over RDLs, lat pull downs, and hip thrusts. So the common mistakes that I see a lot of females making, and basically how to obviously improve your form there. Otherwise, I hope you guys enjoy this workout and I'll see you guys tomorrow. Good morning, so happy Wednesday. So I'm back downstairs at the gym. I'm just gonna get 15 minutes done here on the bike and then 15 minutes on the treadmill. So I missed my cardio session yesterday after my workout just because we just did a lot of filming afterwards and I was so hungry. So I was like, I'm just gonna go home, eat and work. I spent way too long in the gym already. So I'm just gonna double up today. So I'm gonna do 30 minutes now and then I've got shoulders later at the gym and then I'll go on the Stairmaster for another 30 minutes just because I don't wanna leave it all to the end of the week. I've got 6 times 30 minutes, which means I get one day of like rest, but I don't wanna leave it to the end of the week and then be like, oh my God, I run out of time. So I'd rather get it done now since I do have my morning free. Yeah. Also, absolutely love reading. So I've got my, yeah, this is actually what I do. So I typically will put this here and just like read whilst on the bike, just because this is one thick book. But basically I set a goal for myself to go through one book a month, which isn't much, but I'm a very slow reader. I like highlighting, I like kind of like reading back and forth. So I've realized this is 2 birds and 1 stone. It makes cardio go a lot faster and it also just gives me 30 minutes in the day where I can just read, which is obviously really helpful because sometimes I don't find the time to sit down and just read and do something for myself. So this is the perfect combo. So that was 15 kgs on each side. So I'm probably just gonna work my way up to there and just do like one more set here. And then I'm just gonna drop the weight down to probably 10 kgs or 12.5 and then do a few more reps there. And then that will be the shoulder press done. So back from my walk, guys, and this is breakfast. Look how beautiful it is. So we have this like olive bread that I picked up at Carrefour. I don't know how you pronounce it. I think it's Carrefour, but it's a supermarket here. And I've just made 2 eggs here as well. I've just kind of folded it over, but oh, that is the perfect yolk. And then just some veggies here. So that will be breakfast. All right, guys, so just wrapped up a webinar with my business coach and I've just had my pre-workout oats as per usual and I'm gonna go head off and train legs. I kind of look bald, so let's ignore that. We'll be right back. Stairmaster after a brutal leg day is like, I can't imagine anything worse. I need a fucking wheelchair. But that is the third gym session done for this week and the fourth cardio session done. So I've got two more cardio sessions left, one run and then one more leg day, which I'm gonna do on Sunday at Benus.
Back home and we've got dinner here. So we've got some potatoes, salmon from last night, and then sea bass, and then I've just got some bread here.
Cool. Oh my God, I cannot wait to run in the winter.
Oh my fucking God.
All right guys, that is six intervals of 1K done. I feel absolutely wrecked. I'm just gonna cool down now and do like maybe like 2K slow pace. I might hit 10K just for the fun of it. But no, we're gonna cool down, which I don't think is gonna happen until I actually like get out of this country. So back home now and I'm just making some eggs. So just the usual really, like this is all I get up to guys. This is what I eat every single morning for breakfast. I have to have my eggs, I just love them so much. I've got two eggs just frying there and then I've got some mushrooms, onions, some rocket, and then I have my, excuse banana there, that's very overly ripe. Some olive bread here, which is so nice. So yeah, that will be breakfast. All right, so I'm changed and freshened up and I'm just about to go for coffee and basically have a full work day at Kobea.
All right guys, so I am currently still at the cafe. It's been like 5 hours, so I'm probably the most annoying customer because I'm always just sat in one cafe for like the full day. But we've just ordered a very late lunch. Just got basically a bento box here with some beef and then some rice, and then I'm just gonna keep cracking on with work until I feel the need to go home. I'm just currently uploading the next YouTube. Actually, this video will be out by the time you see this video, but basically it's a leg day at Benus. So if you haven't watched that, I will drop the link here. But it was pretty much just a very high volume leg day that you can try out if you wish. Anyways, I'm gonna get back to work, get some food in me because I am starving. I've had like 10 liters of water as well. I've counted. I've literally drank 10 liters and it's like 4 p.m. right now. Your girl is like, I think I probably lost like 5 liters whilst on my run though. So yeah, I need to get myself out of this heat. All right guys, so welcome back. So it is now Sunday, so the final workout of the week. So we've got legs to end off the noose. So I'm just starting off on the abduction machine. I've just had a morning of just filming content. So now it's finally my time just to work out. So we're gonna do abduction and then probably gonna move over onto the hack squat. Just to target the quads, the hamstrings, just pretty much a big compound movement there. And then I'm gonna freestyle it today. I'm very much gonna move to some freestyle a little bit. So we'll see what I feel like after that.